That sounds a lot better. I hope.
Someone tell me if I sound shit. Anyone there? Yeah, I think it's that one. Cool. And of course, desktop audio is now not playing ball. That's why. This is my headphones. Chance. Bramble's getting her chew and is going to settle in for the stream. Big stretch. Yep, she's got her lamb trachea to the side. You're blocking half the fan. No, no. And let's get ourselves ready. Let's hop straight into Homicide. This is going to be case number 2 because I recorded separately case number 1, which you can find. I think I've got my YouTube stuff linked there. Otherwise, this name, but on YouTube. The Golden Butterfly. To those who aren't watching it live, hi, my name's Imperi. Welcome to the LA Noir playthrough. This is the second murder case. If you've missed the others, check and the ones later back. They're great. We've seen. Oh no, she's dropped her keys. Just as this helpful man's come. This not so helpful man has now appeared. There's Cole working early into the morning. That guy, Rusty.
Galloway.
Rusty's desk hasn't moved next to mine yet.
Got it, Skipper.
Uh huh.
Yeah, I'll bring him.
They should put our desks next to each other. You see, we're partners. We're basically best friends.
What have we got?
New case. White female dumped in plain sight in the grass at the end of Hill Street.
No.
Cats are all over it. Catherine's trying to fend them off.
That sounds awfully similar.
Mm-hmm.
The first rule of police work is make no assumptions until you've seen the evidence.
And Skipper, the second rule is that there is no fight club. I assume.
I think I know the place where they found the lady. It overlooks Sunset Boulevard.
Okay.
Let's go.
We're going. Rusty, I would like for you to drive for most of this because I've got much to hello. Heavens, yes. I can be the coming of Jesus. Cole Phelps, Jesus Christ. Basically the same, right?
Trying to imagine you with a personality.
All right, get my gun. You want to talk shit again about you, ma'am? Hmm? You want to try that again? I've pressed... Ah. Did not know I could sit at the bench. That's cool. And we'll stand back up. Robot Phelps is needed elsewhere. Rusty has definitely beat me to the car, so now I have to drive. Bramble's got her chew, which is good. All of the strap I did on that collar, that's really annoying. So that
did a decent job on the Henry case, Phelps.
Thank you.
Not bad for your first time at bat.
I did very well.
Rusty.
Don't go getting ahead of yourself. That's one clearance under Landmark. Your belt.
Ooh.
No assumptions until we see the evidence, right? Right.
Man with a gun, another crime. We get to drive to the live crime. I'm going under the tunnel because fuck everything else. Whoa. Thank you. Where do I go, Rusty?
Up ahead, you make a right.
Up ahead, This right?
Okay, at the next corner, hang a right.
Oh, okay. Oh, fuck it. I'm not listening to you. Whee! Whoa!
KGB on 20 Century Unit. Ah, good. I made it. Man with a gun.
Man. Man with gun.
This is car 11K. Go ahead.
Where is he? Ah, that's not a gun. That's a bullet wound. Would-be robber.
Please, you've got to call for help. He doesn't look real good.
Quick, what happened?
Some punk held up my stand. This guy tried to help and got a bullet for his trouble.
Ow.
He got hit and hightailed it through the parking lot. Get going.
Is that him? I guess that is. He's driving erratic and he's in a very bright yellow car. Well, I assume someone will call for the help for you. Rusty, do your thing. Shoot him. Nope, I will just ram. Oh, wow. Okay. I think... No, he definitely came off worse. Oh, that was a good shot. This man's a professional Rocket League player. We have no chance. Especially if my car is going to get fucked up. Oh, no. Now there's a blue one. Oh, I wanted to double crash into him, make his day even worse. Ah, no! Rusty, your hat.
If you come any closer, I'll pull the trigger.
Put the weapon down, now!
Bang! In the cheek. I think I might have been able to save him. Maybe not. Who knows? Ah, a fire! Sorry, in GTA... I'll go. Oh, fuck you, Rusty. Rusty's so damn lazy. I love it. Ah. Bang. Screw you, cardboard box. One moment. Oh, okay. I think he gave up. Canonically, I'm going to think he just, you know, laid down and gave up. It's fair.
Car 11K calling KGPL. Shots fired. Suspect is down. We're code 4, but I need an ambulance on Grand between 4th
Lots
and
of fired.
Streets.
I did great. Oh, yeah, then. Oh, that's quite late for the ambulance. I hope the guy who got shot is okay. Anyway, Rusty, your turn.
You drive.
Otherwise, we will never get there. I drive us for the fun crime. You drive us for the sad overall crime. The detective stuff. You know what I mean. I didn't bring my water bottle. Shit. Hello. Sorry we're late, Captain. Crimes are happening.
Boys, you know as much as I do. I'll be holding a press conference once the autopsy's been completed. I have two of my finest investigators on the case.
And here are two others who have appeared.
The sword of justice on the crazed sex
Captain, aren't there similarities between this murder and the murder of Celine Henry? And of Elizabeth Short, for that
so you don't
matter.
Believe there's a
How
crazy
do you know?
Sex killer at large
boys,
preying on women?
Boys, be sensible. We have the greatest police force in all the world with the greatest scientific investigators at our disposal. How can any killer continue to be
this
dead?
Guy's incredible. Love him.
Be advised.
Have no faults for the captain.
We keep the
Until
gas
late.
Chamber at San Quentin primed for the sons of Kenyon who continue to believe they can take a life in the City of Angels.
Yeah, right. Any new leads in the Dahlia case?
Run along, boys, and let these officers get to work. We have God's work to do here, and it can't be delayed.
Yeah, you tell him.
What do we have, Captain?
Another woman sacrificed. Speak to Carruthers. I want daily reports, gentlemen.
And I thought this was such a nice area.
All right, we're going to go see the murdered lady.
I was first on scene.
Hello. So investigate.
You find her, Gonzalez?
Not me. A family out for a stroll. I was first reporting.
Oh.
And you show me the body.
We will take the statement.
This way.
A pepper tree? What, like peppercorns?
It's gotta be something big, right?
Interesting. Never really considered where pepper would be grown, but yeah, I guess it makes sense on a tree. In like a bushel. Or something. Who knows?
Can't be much help to you, Phelps.
Why not? Who can't be much help? This is a pepper tree? I guess. Yeah, I can see it. Yep, that's a dead body. What am I seeing? Footprints. Footprints to the dead body.
The stopping angle in the Henry case. Was it reported in the press?
Sure was. Every detail a copycat would want was there in the story.
Ah. So they already know everything. I should probably check. What should I do? Carruthers? Hey, Carruthers.
Similar MO.
What? The Dahlia? I don't think so.
Celine Henry.
That's a closed case. This is probably another sad sack who lost his temper with a broad who wouldn't put out.
Are you a suspect, Rusty?
Watch your mouth, Phelps. All I'm saying is we got enough to do without reopening closed cases.
Talk me through it, Mal.
What if the case was severely slightly
battered,
opened?
On display.
Peaked, in fact.
Footprints would indicate that she has been stomped. Size of the footprints would seem to indicate a smallish men's shoe. What size shoe did Mendez wear?
He wore an 11, I think.
No, I'm not. At a glance, I would say strangulation is the cause of death. I'll need to do further tests for semen.
Mm-hmm.
Angry boyfriend. They were married, they'd be at home. Not humping out here in Lover's Lane.
You mind if I examine the body?
And Rusty, very quick to be like, nah, not this. All right, I'm already investigating the body. Anyone who's squeamish, look away. Or, you know, yeah, actually, no. Look away. I don't want you gone.
Looks like she was tied up.
Ouchie.
It does it first, but that would leave a mark on her other wrist, too. I think her watch might have been torn off.
It was indeed a watch who was ripped off. Those are some footprints. Jesus. This other arm. Uh-huh. Wedding ring gone.
What's this mark? A cut on a finger.
Very deep.
Fourth finger, left hand. A wedding or engagement ring. Violently removed.
Man. Yeah, so missing watch and ring. And we haven't checked the head yet. So signs of looks like rope or
look
tires.
Mark is very
distinctive.
Yeah, rope pattern or someone on a small tricycle.
Back to you.
Okay, I think that's everything on the body. Now check this good hairbrush. Oh no, it's a bag. A name.
Well, we have a name. Can you run Deirdre Muller by R&I?
Oh, the Muller.
Back in
case.
A second.
Deirdre Muller, Parent-Teacher Association. Oh, she's part of the PTA. And a tip for me.
It was robbery. Why not take the money?
It was not a robbery murder. And I will not be tipped extra, it seems. Okay, that's all the cases. Rusty,
R&I says that Deirdre Muller of 130 North Bonnie Bray was reported missing this morning by her husband,
Hugo
Muller.
We're going to have to go and break the bad news.
Grab the husband, take him downtown, and work him over. Get have this wrapped up by lunchtime.
But
what about
he,
not making assumptions and going on the evidence?
He wouldn't report her, surely. Who are these two who are waiting by our car?
All these cars.
By someone else's car.
It's a big, right?
No, by our car, indeed.
Don't
thank you.
Be standing around.
Police business.
Shouldn't you be working?
KTI Radio. La la la. A Chevrolet sedan. Is Rusty here yet? Rusty, barge through the women. That's not like you, Rusty. Gore. Alright, don't crash. Hey, see? Didn't crash. Yeah. Rusty, tell us your life story.
Still might be some play in the boyfriend angle.
I thought we were on our way to lock up the husband.
If he doesn't work out, then.
Deirdre Muller.
Whoopsie.
Whoa there.
I was taking a shortcut. Whoa. You were saying?
Deirdre Muller has suffered enough. More than enough. You shouldn't make disparaging comments about her without even the slightest inkling of what she was like.
She was a woman, wasn't she? Well, around about my third divorce, I realized women might not be the pure angels we imagine.
There is a common denominator in that, Rusty. One
don't
over three.
Don't make any insinuations about my wife.
Hey, whoa. She's a woman.
She's the mother of my children.
Cole has
you're
children.
You're a father, Cole? But don't tell me your eye don't bend.
This conversation is over.
Yeah, shoot him. Why do I have two messages saying welcome to the chat room? Huh. Is anyone out there? Or is Twitch just reminding me twice? Is it because of... Oh, I was having issues trying to get the title out because Eleanor was being like, pay attention to me. And then because of that, I couldn't actually put the title. But hey, two welcomes to the chat room. That's damn good. La 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 la. Going to arrest the husband for some reason. Rusty, what way?
Take the next right.
The next right? Oh. I thought it'd be straight on. Whoa, whoa, whoa! Ah, much better. Don't die! Man, Rusty, police work is sure tiring. nice, quick, wrapped-up case. Hey. What up, Rosie? Caught me just in time to fall asleep at the wheel. Right into this person's house. Oh, no!
Help!
Oh, hang on. It was the next house. Sorry. I crashed into the neighbors. The jazz music continues in the cutscene. Cool. Good to know. Jazz music stayed in the back. Alright, hang on. Let's just peer through the window. Is someone home? Oh, there is. A woman reading with her back to the door. She's too comfortable. Ah, bad cop, worst cop back. Who would I be? I think the worst cop is... No, bad cop's Rusty. I am worst cop. Because I am leading this mess.
Phelps and Galloway, LAPD.
Uh-huh.
Is your father home?
He'll be home soon.
Oh, it's the child. It's a child with
What's
adult
your name,
face.
Miss?
Michelle Eloise Mahler.
Okay, thanks for the full name. In? What's your security number? That is not a child. That is not. That is three goblins in a trench coat. It's a good thing we did get let in. There are some bananas on the table. Rusty's very confused. He's never seen a woman that small. Or that young.
We're going to have a look around.
We're going to steal your shit, kid. That's a mighty fine Hoover. Ah, makeup. Something dinged. I must check the violin. Or the cello. Some kind of instrument. Where's the string?
Explain everything when he gets back, okay?
Oh, he's actually being reasonable to the child. That is unlike Rusty. Let's read her diary.
Doesn't tell me anything.
No, it can tell us everything. Open the book. Someone is listening to the radio. Some boots. Are they the size 8s we've been looking for, Stomper Stomper? Oh my god, they are.
Size 8s.
Oh no. I've seen The Orphan. Yes, I have seen The Orphan. Yep. She looks like the woman from The Orphan. This is the DLC that completely turns. Now it's a horror game. I was thinking about The Orphan actually last week. So it was like, oh, I kind of was in the mood for a horror film that's quite odd. And I was getting flashbacks to that scene.
The same one snatched from her body.
Alright, stolen watch. Piece of evidence that's disappeared. And, oh wait, a ring. Whoa.
No sign of a wedding ring.
Yep, jewelry's missing. That matches. And there is a ring. Oh, can I open the window? Was that everything, really? Okay, a double bed. That... I feel like that was quite early for the time. I'm going off of... I now can't remember the film, so you guys might know. Tobey Maguire and... I can't remember her name. But they get sucked into a 50s sitcom. And then as they do stuff, color starts to return. Because they're like liberate or something. I'm pretty certain the introduction to the double bed was part of that as well. Or maybe I'm wrong. Who knows? Maybe this family really did like each other. Which is why he Goomba stomped her a couple of times. Anyway, child, I don't know how to break this to you, so I hope the game can.
Daddy is trying to find
Schindler's
her.
Schindler's List.
Just tell me she's okay.
Ah, yes. I remember in Schindler's List when they got the double bed.
Your mother is dead.
Ah, okay. He broke that nicer than I did. That does make him worse cop.
Do you think you could answer a few questions for us?
All right, I'll give you 5 seconds to grieve.
Try.
She gave up real quick. That's, yeah, you're not real. 15? You look 8. This is a 15-year-old. Right, daughter of murder victim, Deirdre Muller. Okay, it wasn't her one. Tell us about her jewelry.
Some of her mother's jewelry was missing. Can you describe her things?
Ring, a watch.
A rope necklace.
I never paid much attention to that stuff.
I guess that's correct. Was there anything else? I don't trust this child. If I was to use intuition, 99%. Screw it. What do you guys think? Oh, it was true. Oh.
I know.
Maybe I should trust.
This may be important. She wore a wedding ring?
Mommy chose it herself.
Oh.
a rose gold wedding band and a matching diamond and ruby engagement ring.
She wore a watch?
Not silver.
Yes. A yellow gold Elgin watch. Daddy bought it for her birthday.
Right, hang on. She just said, yep, some jewelry. And now she's been very specific. Very specific. I can tell you the band. I can tell you the actual gem. For a 15-year-old. Who, it looks 7. Last contact.
When did you last see your mother?
Can you give us precise time?
I went to a dance at Belmont High.
Mm-hmm.
Mommy was supposed to pick me up, but she didn't show.
So what did you do then?
I was upset. Daddy came instead.
Okay. All right, yeah. Again, no reason to lie. You lied to police?
Did he come and get you?
Of course. Some boys offered me a ride home, but that's not the right thing to do.
So you were hanging around the school for quite a while. What happened with your father?
He started drinking.
No.
Oh.
I called and called, and finally he answered.
He lied to Minette? I don't understand the Minette joke. I assume that's something Baldur's Gate related. Or is it just the meme of the cat? Because otherwise I think it is Baldur's Gate. Or this is Minette. You heathen, you lied to police. Now I'm going to go all mad on you. I don't care.
Happily married?
I'm going to scream at you.
What are you saying? Of course they are.
Lies!
I think your father was violent with your mother.
It's just a cat meme.
I think they weren't very happy. And you should tell me, young lady...
You may be family the police, but you have no right to talk about my mom and dad like that.
It's not Baldur's Gate related. Alright, I screamed. So, what was I doing again? So, I just shouted at a child. I think your father was violent. I think they weren't very happy and you should tell me. You may be pleased, but you have no right to talk to my mom like that. Alright, how do I proof? Hang on. Wait. What's going home with no husband? With no answer. Oh, it wasn't specifying about the makeup thing. Why am I hearing a dog whimpering? And it's not mine. Bramble's asleep next to my golf clubs. Doubt. Yes.
They weren't happy, were they, Michelle? Did your father ever hit your mother?
Just once.
But she was talking smack.
If he ever did it again.
See?
He bought her a brooch pin to make up for it.
So that's more jewelry.
And he always wore her golden butterfly.
I feel like she kind of wore that to mock him.
Thanks, Miss Muller. You've been very brave.
Sorry about your mother.
Hey! What gives?
Daddy, the police are here.
We're having a party.
I'll talk to the police.
Daddy,
just a little domestic violence. Just a little pitter-pat.
You can't come in here interrogating her like she's some
kind
of...
Your wife was found murdered this morning.
Again, Cole, great.
Found?
Great breaking it.
What?
Is that the cop from Heroes?
But she only...
I have not seen Heroes. I don't even know, like, the main cast of this.
There's some questions that we would like to ask you.
Have you understood? Sure, yeah. Is that because he couldn't break family deaths very well either? Now I've got loads of questions. You're 46. I like the drawing was you mid-shout as well. Hey, bud. You're sitting quite calm. It's very nice. Footprints.
What size shoe do you wear, Mr.
Where's Bowen? Your foot?
Why do you ask?
It's routine, sir. Simple process of elimination.
Do they smell?
Nines, I think.
That's a lie.
Why are you lying to me, Mr. Muller?
Why would I lie to you at a time like this?
Because you have a small penis. That and also your boots are this size.
That's funny. The work boots we found here are size 8s.
Ah, you got that wrong.
Why lie about it if you've got nothing to hide?
Hey, because you know, I always get teased.
I mean, I'd say right
feet.
Now I don't know what size my shoes are.
You know, small
They're
feet.
They're probably
small.
An 8 or a 9.
Always been true in my experience.
Thanks, Rusty. Agitate the witness for me. I mean, I'm already doing that as well. What's your missing
you
persons report?
A missing persons report this morning?
Yeah, that's right. My wife didn't come home last night. She left around 9:30. Michelle was out at dance. She called me to let me know that Deidre didn't turn up.
Mm-hmm. Shit, hang on. There was something more to that. Allow me to view my notebook. Husband's alibi was Michelle reports calling home repeatedly with no answer. So that's a lie.
And you didn't report that she was missing till this morning? That's very unusual, Mr. Muller. Not to mention suspicious.
Mm. Yikes.
Look, I was annoyed with her. That's why I was waiting for her to come home. Why, you telling me something different?
Yes. But let me check. What was my question? You phoned in a missing persons report. Yeah, that's right. My wife didn't come home. Yeah, my wife didn't come home last night. She left around 9:30. Michelle was at a dance. She called me to let me know that Deidre didn't turn up. But we do have the alibi that they called home and he didn't answer. So yeah, screw it. Double lie. Shit.
You better think about leaving, or you're going to have some trouble on your hands.
I have a gun, sir. Totally is. Wish I could send a picture in chat. Mark Parkman. Okay. So that's Cole. Or Rusty. No, it's Cole. Alibi. Okay, I'm just going to quote the alibi back to you again. You now have a chance to regurgitate it.
Yes, that's correct.
Lie. That's a lie. That's a lie.
If you're having an affair, or if there's something going on. I told you I was here. Were you saying I wasn't?
Yeah, let me try the same bit of evidence again. Hey, see?
So
knew that was going to be useful.
So long to answer the phone when your daughter called?
Because my dick was wet.
Okay, I went out for a while. I was driving around. It's my way of relaxing.
I take a baseball bat and I hit the mailboxes. Movements of the victim. How is your wife moving?
Went to pick up Michelle. Yes, that's right.
In the cutscene we saw at the start, that was correct. I'm going to doubt you. Shit.
What happened, Hugo? You got any theories? Because we're starting to like you for this.
Oh, man.
The car park by the school is kind of dark.
How would you know if you weren't hiding in the bushes?
Somebody jumped there. Did you try the parking lot?
I came here immediately. Tell us about your violence.
And then strangled. In your case, you have no alibi and a history of violence towards your wife. That's not true, God damn it.
Good thing I spoke to your daughter.
You're a violent man.
Cole basically just went,
Sometimes you lost control. Your daughter and your wife were scared of you.
Take that.
You don't know anything about me.
I do, because of Ala Butterfly Brooch.
I know about the Golden Butterfly, Hugo, and how you bought your wife off the last time
I liked he could have faked it to be like, we know all
like
about
money,
the
right?
Chinese
dresses, jewelry, her hair. It drove me goddamn crazy.
What? Why would
I look
her
like
hair?
A Rockefeller?
Nobody likes a cheapskate, Hugo.
I don't get it. What about
her
hair?
With us is a very bad idea, Hugo.
Hit him.
I'm no murderer.
Hit him.
Make some arrangements for your daughter and then present yourself to Central Station for questioning.
Still, same amount
of
experience.
You gotta be kidding me, Phelps. Put the cuffs on him.
This is an outrage. I didn't kill my wife. Your daughter is in the next room, Mueller, so I'm giving you a break.
Ooh.
Don't make me change my mind and don't make me come looking for you.
You should have just shot him, Phelps.
You should go back in there and bust his ass.
Yeah, just to surprise
him.
One,
we need to break his alibi. Check phone records, canvass the neighbors. Two, we have motive of domestic violence, which probably goes for half the men in L.A. Three, we have no evidence tying him to the crime scene.
Ah, the neighbor wants to peruse.
Hello, detective!
I have so much shit to tell you. Quick, run across the street. I was real lucky I didn't get hit by
a
car.
Yes, ma'am.
I heard the terrible news over the radio.
And you can help us with our inquiries?
Yes, sir.
Eh?
They had a row last night. I heard Mrs. Mueller screaming.
She
did you see
screams
Mrs. Mueller
often.
Come home late last night at all?
No, not at all. I did see Mr. Mueller put something in the incinerator earlier this morning, though.
Oh.
I told you he was our guy. Now let's get this bum downtown and into a cell.
Look, there he is now.
Why is he running? Okay. He's double burning. Oh, you start a fire real quick.
Step away from the incinerator.
Prisoners in the prison would like to know how quickly you start fires.
No shooting. We need this guy to make the case.
I'm going to... I have to go this way. I make fast. Finally, first tackle. First tackle. Yeah. We got him. Ah, a shoe. Were you burning the body? Two shoes covered in blood. That's curious.
This doesn't look good, Hugo.
I can explain the blood.
Oh, can you?
Get him booked in.
Is it steak sauce?
Then put him in an interview room. We'll be speaking with him later. And inform the cat.
Yes, sir, detective.
Is there someone you can call?
I don't remember this cutscene.
I don't know. It's a moment.
You need somewhere to stay, Michelle. You have other family? Grandparents? Aunts or uncles?
Call Aunt Helen, but she lives in Acresfield and...
Call her.
Great, don't care,
get
bye.
Someone down here from Juvenile Hall to talk to you in the meantime.
All right, see you later, orphan.
We ought to get some uniforms down here, clean up, take care of the kid.
Yeah, maybe we should.
There's such a thing as soap, you know.
Shut the fuck up, you.
This is a busy street, okay?
I wish I could pull my gun. Rusty's already going in the car, that means I have to drive. Oh.
Homicide division, badge number 564.
Oh, he's calling him in. Thanks, Rusty.
Go ahead, detective unit.
Can we we get Ray Pinker and a technical services team to a house at 130 North Bonnie Bray Street.
She's gonna fuck your dad.
Send someone down from juvenile hall.
She's gonna fuck your dad in prison.
Roger, 11K. Well, inform Detective Phelps that the coroner has a report waiting.
Oh, boy.
Police board downtown when he's available.
Got it, KGPL.
Right, return Central Morgue. Wait, do I have to... I think I've also got to make a phone call. Rusty, why can't you do all the phone calls on the radio? Thank you. Yep. Quick, call him up. She's going to fuck my dad.
Phelps, 1247.
Uh-huh. How can I help, Detective?
How can I help, Detective?
I need an address on a Belmont high school.
Checking for you, Detective.
Mm-hmm.
Belmont High, 1575 West 2nd Street.
Thanks, ma'am.
Bramble's put herself right under the golf club.
Top of my class, back east. Now I'm waiting table.
One moment, Rusty. Hang on. I don't know if you guys, how well you can see. You might be able to just see her ears. She's woken up. Remember, I need to hit 30, and then next time I'll turn the camera on. I can see the golf bag. Yep, she's under that. Hopefully you saw the ears. I need to go to the... Let's go to the morgue. La la. So I know there's someone else that you find at the high school, and I don't know if it's best if I go to the morgue first. Anyway, Rusty can drive today.
I'm surprised, you know. I didn't make the husband for him.
Mm.
Always make the husband, Phelps. 9 times out of 10, it's the closest person to the Vic who does the deed. God knows I've wanted to kill some wives in my life.
But what about
Lex
the one?
Parsimonii.
That's a big word.
The law of parsimony. Occam's razor. The simplest explanation is most likely...
Whoa!
You know, you could have said that without getting all liturgical on.
I'll try to dumb things down from now on.
Appreciate it. Try this one on for size. Rusty's razor.
How's that go?
You blame the guy.
I go first. Me, please.
Ah, of course. The famous Lex Ignoramus.
Uh-huh. Close his cases, Cole. Puts a lot of people away, that one.
Whoa. No! Another crime!
Oh. West 2nd Street. Stand by for further unit to handle. Identify code 2.
Was that someone creeping at us?
11K to KGPL. We'll take the 288. Go ahead with the further.
All units, officer needs help. 211 and shots fired.
Oh my god, three crimes are happening. We need more police officers. Is this what it's like being a police all day? Not only have I got to go and speak to the mortician, I now have to deal with a shots fired case and someone at the school. Alright, tell the bullets to wait. I'll speak with the morgue. And then I will go ahead and pick up the other one. Where am I going?
Go right through here.
Oh, okay, right through here. Thank you. Oh, yeah, siren. Can I go that way? Nope, that was a tunnel. Whoa! That truck, I'm sure, is fine. He's fine. One day you'd think I'd actually, you know, considering I have driven, I would get better. You guys, never. No, my eyes need to be on chat. I need to know what's happening at all times, every time. Actually, if I played it through this, no, that just does not look as good. That's a shame. Anyway, take this corner. Oh, thread the needle. You saw that. That was good. I get my moments. I was sure that was going to be another kill on my eyes.
Go to hell, Parker! No way. I'm going
yeah, see?
Down fight.
And now, oh, now let's watch
drop
me.
Drop the weapon, hands behind
move.
Your head.
Yeah?
Fuck you, too!
Quick call, stop you're the war hero.
Your hands in the air.
Where is he? Shoot, what? What? How? Oh. Are you always out of reach?
Give it up!
Damn it. Jump the box. Oh. Where are you?
Don't make me chase you!
Bang, 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 bang!
Oh my god!
Not even gonna give you a chance. You fired at us. Shoot him down. Are we getting a Hot Fuzz style foot chase? Nope.
This is Kari Levin King.
Advise all units that the 211 from Mallory's Cafe is code 4, KGPL.
Thank
you. 211K, all units, 211 from Mallory's Cafe is code 4, repeat, code
4. Oh, yeah. Right. Hey, have I unlocked another outfit? Hell yeah. Rusty, you drive. I need to lament on how incredible that was. The outsider outfit. Huh. I don't know where we're going. So this is new to me. I initially picked the morgue, but then we had a second thing of the high school. Then I fired a gun at someone. We're going to the morgue. That's good. Luckily, children move slow, so I guess we can capture the guy who's perving on them. Mortuary Nat entrance. Okay, well, we need the day entrance then, obviously. Where would that be? I don't have time. It's late at night. Oh, good. The door does open. Passwords.
Phelps? Hello. Rusty? Thanks for coming.
Thank you for having us.
Can you untype the shoes that we bagged and see if they're a match?
Sure. It'll all be in the report, but I'm assuming you want the details now?
Please. Cause of death is strangulation?
Mm-hmm. Correct. Take a look at the samples on the bench.
Look at this cool stuff we have on the bench. Uh-huh. I see a rope. This middle one looks kind of cool. Hmm. Game's not said anything yet, so possibly not that one. How about this one? Yes.
What are the normal uses for that kind of rope?
On boats, mooring lines.
Mm-hmm. I like boats.
Correct. Although Ray says that they're sometimes used as bell ropes in churches.
I see. Bell rope.
So are we and looking for a sailor or a minister?
Well, in my experience, sailors seem to have the greater libido.
Was Mrs. Muller criminally attacked?
No external or internal traces of semen.
Thanks, ma'am. Anything else comes up, you let us know.
Okie dokie. How is she doing, by the way? You're doing great.
We've got to nail this guy.
I don't know what's in there. It looks like some kind of worm. So, yucky body stuff. I will leave you to it, mortician. I'm going to use your phone anyway. I need to throw up down it. Where? What? Huh? Where's your... Oh, there's your phone. Excuse me. Excuse me. Pardon me. Excuse me. Thank you. Phone now. Sit down.
Operator,
put your feet
give
up.
Give me R&I.
Now.
Phelps, badge 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
Could you not brush in here? I'm clearly on an important call.
Yes, Detective. A green 1946 coupe registered to Mrs. Hugo Muller has been found in the parking lot adjoining the Belmont High School in Plainfields. Captain Donnelly wants you to head down there immediately to take the school janitor's statement.
Okay.
Thank you.
So the car was abandoned. I think. What? Rusty, those hand movements sending me crazy. Now, I think I drove... No, I drove to the last crime. So I'll drive again. And hopefully no more crime appears. Is that appearing jittery to you? Or is it smooth? I think it's smoothed. I'll drive my treat, Rusty. We're going to high school. Unless it's really far away. Who beeps at me?
Not exactly the happiest of places, the coroner's office.
Carruthers is a good man, professional.
I will not have you talking shit about Carruthers.
A pro, it's easy to overlook the grim realities of a place like that.
Funny job, that, the coroner's.
How so?
You know, you don't want them enjoying their work too much. The wrong kind of man can get awfully lonely rattling around a joint full of corpses.
Rusty, that's like something out of the pulps.
Been reading the same ones as me?
I thought you were usually too drunk to get through a magazine.
Oh.
You know, if I close one eye and squint, you can just about make out the print.
Ah, good old Rusty. Getting super drunk. Don't you dare. LA is a filthy place. There are so many crimes. Code 3, I think, was a gun. A shootie. And this is some music they put on.
Easy.
It's all right, Rusty. I used that to help turn the corner. Why is this music scratching that itch? What is this xylophone-ass music? I don't know, but it just seems to be fitting so well. Ah! Okay, no, we did it. We're good. We're going this way. I think the worry is when I start getting too good at the driving in Eleanor. Big turn. No, the gunshot scared me. Oh, no, that was your fault. You ran into that. Alright, yeah, a lot of gunshots. Alright, where am I needed? Okay, I see them in the hats. Cop killer shot. Ouch. That was a big shot.
Hello. That alleyway leads to the rear of the building, sir. Someone's gonna have to climb up and take him down.
Good luck. Don't let him get a bead on you like I did.
A bead? Go, Rusty, go. Alright, I'm a war hero. Whoa, bring down 30 bad guys with a headshot. Everyone saw that. Oh, that guy also died. Whoops. La la la. Huh? What? How did... How the hell... Oh, up this pole. Okay. Two cops show in one day, and that's why you have to solve every crime. Yeah, I know. I'm here with Rusty. All the patrolmen are like, quick, call Cole Phelps. We can't deal with it. And on top of that, I have to remember to interview people properly. Who are they firing at? Oh!
Am I killing cops?
Hello. Hello. Bang, bang. I was in the war. You had no chance.
But these guys are done.
Okay. They're already done, Cole. Thanks for the exposition, though. Ah. Killed a lot of people today. Hey, Carruthers. I think he's mad at me because I have put so many bodies in his morgue. He's like, damn it, Cole. We're still holding the gun. Good time. Let's go drinking. Why was my gun still out? Because I need to look cool. Hey, I got that accomplishment too. All right, Rusty, just so it's not as fun. Go on, you can drive. No, we have to use... That's our... The gun is like more prevalent than a drink coaster at this stage. Okay, that was an interesting horn to end that bit. I want my gun out in the next one. Belmont High School. 6:17 p.m. Why are the cars still here? I know there's one abandoned one. Hi, janitor. Do you get paid?
This is the car?
Yes, sir, detective.
Uh-huh.
Have you looked it over?
Superficially. I was told to wait for you guys.
I have identified it's a car.
What time did you see the person park the car?
Late last night, after school social, maybe 1 a.m. I've been keeping a good eye out lately. We've had problems with the child molester.
And this was the same man?
I don't know, sir. I mean, I'd like to say yes, but... Truth is, it was pretty dark.
All right. Tell me about this man you've been having trouble with.
He hangs near the playground, tries to befriend the children. He was around here last night before.
What the hell?
Is he violent?
Yes, sir, I would say so, yes. There's the son of a bitch now!
Why was he creeping there?
Go, Phelps, I'll take the car and see if I can cut him off.
Take the bike. If I can't get this one, I'm doing that. I don't know why he was just creeping around like that. Oh, good, they'll never know. Cole, pull out your gun. Prove that I run track. Someone help. Come on, Cole. Speedy Gonzalez. Up the stairs. Where did he go? Across the road. Tackle him in traffic. Just shout he's a child molester. Then that car will hit him. I'm the only cop. Why... I would like to go into the tackle animation. Yoo-hoo. Come on, Cole. Come on, Cole.
Come on. Yes, here we go.
Get him before the wall. Oh, you prick. Oh. You don't know who he is. Why didn't you do anything? Throw your coffee on him. Tackle him before the wall. Tackle him before the wall. For fuck's sake, Cole. Tackle, tackle. In the dustbin. In the bowl. In the wall. Nah, you're too nice to him. I should have tackled him, firstly, 30 fucking seconds ago.
What's your name?
And also, I should have pushed him into the wall.
Who's asking?
I have chased you like crazy, and now you're not going to talk.
Name's Eli Rooney.
Ah, thank you.
Been in trouble with the law before, Eli?
Some.
What are you doing around here?
I like to keep an eye on the children.
Strictly paternal, is it, Eli?
Why are you admitting this? Boy.
A woman was abducted here last night, Eli, and murdered.
And I would love to make you for that, you oaking motherfucker.
Okay.
Well, I wouldn't know nothing about that. A woman, you say? I like him a little younger than that.
Turn out your pockets,
Eli. Yeah, this
Eli.
Guy's being super
Why
arrested.
Why would I do that?
Because I'm about to break your fucking skull, Eli.
I like that he's being so blasé and admitting all of this to us. It's because he knows. Hang
You're
on.
You're under arrest, Eli. You are in very deep trouble.
I like you handing that to us immediately. Thanks. I'll put that.
Why bother with the paperwork, Eli? I'm going to take out my gun, and I'm going to count to five.
Good idea.
Let's see how fast you can run now.
He can run very fast, Rusty.
Hang on a goddamn minute. I found that thing in the parking lot.
Get some backup out here, Rusty. We need to get this one downtown and into a cell.
Yes. I'm not a murderer, I promise. Just an innocent nonce. I didn't kill that woman. I just touched the kids. You can't get me on that now, can you? Some people. Anyway, what's in the car? Wow. And this was in the boot.
Blood and skin samples. Rope. We better get Ray Pinker out here.
I swear this doesn't happen that often. I just need to give my noodle a good tug. You're very pretty. This tire wrench, whatever it is.
It's from a Chrysler. Could be important.
A Chrysler. Cole, I'll move that immediately.
The overalls are stenciled HM. Muller is a mechanic.
Ah, His Majesty. It was the King of England. Now I have to call Central. Excuse me, Rusty. Going out for a light jog. Whoa! Got a call.
Phelps, badge 1247.
How can I help, Detective?
I need interrogation set up at Central for both suspects being held in the Mahler homicide.
Well done for getting over the wall, Rusty.
Certainly, Detective. I'll get in touch with the watch commander.
Thanks.
Thank you. Alright, Rusty, I'm going to touch the car door. Ha ha ha. That means you have to drive.
You're behind the wheel. And where exactly are we going?
It's been a long day for these guys. But also, it's interesting to know that they can solve a case in one day. They're like, a woman died this morning. Alright, we've already arrested
her. I say
someone.
We make Rooney for this. I think we should lay it on him. He
what?
Was near the car, he had her jewelry, the DA will love him for it.
But
even if he didn't do it?
Who cares whether he did it? You have kids, Phelps?
Just shoot him.
He needs to be taken permanently out of harm's way.
And we let Mueller slide?
For a while. He gets a free pass for now.
Okay, you get a free pass for murdering your wife because there's someone else we hate more. That's the Rusty way. Central Police Station. Let's go.
Better not go soft on me in here, Phelps.
Like that rope.
Rusty. Let him do the rest.
Hello.
Are they ready?
Bowler's in two and the pervert's in one. Get in there and get a conviction.
All right. Who are we going to first? What's that? I have to stand up. No, I would not like to.
Isn't that the cop who won the medal and is solving all the cases?
I am. I am the cop that has that medal. All right, interview room two. Mahler, good.
I saved a whole year for that.
Hello.
Here's where we stand, Hugo.
Your next door neighbor heard screaming coming from
Cuff the cons.
You were burning your blood-stained shoes.
What about this
man? No one who can confirm your whereabouts last night. Your daughter says you're a violent man. We have everything we need to send you to death row, and all you have to say for yourself is I didn't do it.
I swear I didn't kill her.
Oh, he swears it now.
Give me that lie test. I can prove it.
The test that you can fake? No. Cuff Mueller as well. All right, you, I'm addressing because you're a child molester, and you, because I don't like you.
Why did you burn your shoes, Hugo?
Yeah, this big one.
Because I knew you'd never believe me.
That's, I mean, yeah, we wouldn't have believed you. Okay, sure. Yeah, we probably not. Cool.
Believe what?
It's rabbit's blood. A guy at work brought him in, and I helped.
Mueller, Esther. Oh my God, you've cracked the case, Rosie. And Rooney, more like Roo needs to murder. Is that good? He didn't seem to like that. Okay.
Do you know anything about ropes?
Yeah, why you got rope?
As much as the next man. I was a scout. I learned some more in the army.
Sure. Why'd you look scared? Let's press. There's more to that. There
you
was.
Like to strangle with the rope in the army?
With rope, with my bare hands, but mainly with wire. I learned a lot of things in the army, but I still didn't kill my wife.
I learned how to kill my wife, but I didn't do it.
What type of rope would you use?
If I had to, I would use a triple braid. Less flex, easier control.
He was simply being like, I didn't kill my wife. How would you kill your wife? Oh, well, I would kill her like this.
Your wife was beaten with a tire iron, Hugo. An appropriate choice of tool for a mechanic.
He's not really showing any, like, sadness any besides his head iron. Down. He doesn't know anything about a tire iron. Well, that's a doubt, a lie. Wait, we can... Hang on. Evidence. One moment. There's a bloody tire iron in your car. Stained with blood found in the trunk of her one and green work overalls. Yeah, lie.
You're lying, Hugo. You're going to have to come clean on this.
You got no proof.
No proof of what? Mueller, what did I ask? What did I ask? Seriously, what did I ask? Your wife was beaten with a tire iron, an appropriate choice of tool for a mechanic. I know nothing about any tire iron. But look, bloody tire iron, which, okay, yeah, you wouldn't have known. Stained with blood found in the trunk of her car. But there are green work overalls stained with blood with your initials. It's probably this. It's telling me to back out. I don't know, man. Let's back out.
Sorry. My mistake.
I'm going to use an intuition point, and I'm going to be furious if it turns out it is a lie. 89%? Son of a bitch! It was a lie! Right, we're going back to that lie. It's the... This. So it's got HM. Bugger! It was a tire iron. You want an attorney?
I'm not answering any more questions unless I get an attorney.
All right, would you answer one more, though? Just one more question,
please.
Found
your wife's car. Someone parked it at the school late last night. Do you have anything to say about that?
It wasn't me.
I'm glad he answered the question. It's great.
Where do you keep your work clothes?
I keep them at work in my locker.
Sure, maybe. I'm going to doubt you. Oh, God damn it.
It was you, Hugo. Okay. I'm offering you a chance to come clean on this.
I bet that was another lie. Does intuition use data credit from other players?
Kill my wife.
I don't know how it does it through Steam, but I know on Xbox it was for, you know, players who played the game, they chose that answer. There was one way back in the previous case, which you wouldn't have seen live, but you would have seen on the video, where I'm pretty certain the community was 30% correct on one question, because it was just genuinely a difficult question. Like, the dude gave up nothing. I don't even know what the correct answer was. I think it didn't matter. You got it right or wrong, you got roughly the same bit.
Boys,
where am I going?
You've really come through this time, haven't you?
Hey, Captain.
We were on our way to interview Eli Rooney.
Yes, Phelps, I know. This particular fiend is an old acquaintance.
An old acquaintance?
I have tried to reaffirm his belief in a wrathful and terrible God.
I've tried to hit him.
Whichever way it goes, I'll be dealing personally with him.
Actually, I think you did hit him. You were just checking out your hands, weren't you? How's your face, Rooney?
You look like you've had it rough.
Damn. Yep.
See me asking for your sympathy, boy?
Shoot. Just put him down. Alleged child sex offender. He has admitted it twice. Where'd you work?
On your luck, Eli.
I've had worse. My family ate roadkill during the Dust Bowl.
Ooh. But you have a job.
What's the Dust Bowl?
A parolee has to have a job, correct?
I had me a job down in San Pedro. I'm looking for something new.
Uh-huh. San Pedro. Don't know what that is. I'm sure that's correct. We could just call up to find out. So, yeah. God damn
what
it.
What kind of job you like?
Working fishing boats, odd jobs Peter. Around the boat.
Damn, yard. Rosie, you are on fire.
Pretty good, my hands.
You should interview nonsense. And you can be like, no, you.
You ever tie up any of your victims, Eli?
Uh-huh.
It's not a nice thing to go call them that.
What would you call them?
I can't say.
Yeah.
I learned a long time ago not to go talk about the things I like.
I want them to mod talk and add an option, which is just press RT or R2 and just fire your gun. You.
See what I mean? Short answer is yes.
So,
do you have any
it?
Preference regarding rope,
you
Eli?
Use rope.
I know a good rope from a bad rope, if that's what you mean.
Give me more.
That's not what you mean, is it?
I doubt it. I am going to press.
Any old rope will do me fine.
Any old rope? No. What? Hmm. I don't know. I'm just going to lie.
You're lying, Eli. You're a creature of habit. You just get out of jail and you're back to your old ways. You use a specific type of rope.
Uh-huh.
That may be the case. But you got nothing that says I used a rope to hurt that woman.
There was rope found in the car, which you don't have access to. Rope pattern. Nope. There is rope. Length of rope stained with blood found in the trunk of Deirdre Miller's vehicle. Hmm. Alright, I'm doing it again.
Sorry. Sometimes you have to shake the tree to see what falls out.
Just because I need to make sure that I get one correct intuition on him. 99.4. Yeah, so 99.4 of players chose the correct answer after using an intuition point. We asked community. Oh, he was telling the truth. Three.
Farm boy like you, Eli, must prefer McGay for roping. Am I right?
I prefer braid. Tie hitching braid. It stays tied.
Okay, I don't know what that meant in
you
relation
killed
to
Mrs.
it.
Mueller
sure.
And stole her jewelry.
That ain't so. Ain't done nothing like that.
You were holding her jewelry. Why was doubt like really highlighted? Or am I just going weird? That's a lie.
You're a liar, Eli. You needed the money, so you killed her.
Okay, that's a stretch.
I've been around some, son. You got some evidence that proves I stole that butterfly from that woman?
You had the butterfly. Missing watch, rope pattern, men's work boots, butterfly brooch. Oh, he did say he found it in the parking lot.
Looks like I was mistaken.
Okay. How are you now? God, you're angry. I'm going to push you and punch you in the face. Yes.
You have no job and nowhere to live by the smell of things. And you need money. You've been in trouble
you're
before,
ugly and you smell.
Who do you think a jury will believe?
I've been in trouble for other things, but I ain't never killed no one. I saw that car coming to the parking lot late last night.
Uh-huh.
Man got changed there and put his coveralls in the trunk. I saw him drop the butterfly in the lamplight, and he strolled out, cool as you like. And I went over and I picked it up.
I don't like you, Eli. I think you're an evil
I
man.
I hate you.
I think you try to pass off your pain to other people. I can't make you for this case. But my consolation is that I don't think you will be out of prison for very long.
You can count on it, shitbird. By the way, Eli, the captain and the hat squad would like to talk to you next. Any idea what they might want to talk about?
Huh?
That's the guy. Detective. That's him. That's the guy who parked the car. I'm sure of it. Hey, he's getting away.
What the hell? I don't remember this.
That's not true. I can't go to jail.
Okay. Case opened up. I now have to apprehend you. All right, so everything's pointing to Hugo. The fact that Cole even was like, I can't put it on you.
What? Be closer.
One moment. I didn't mean to be caught like that or scream. I would like to formally apologize. And now we're going to apprehend Hugo nice and swift.
Hit it! Clean this asshole off the road!
Oh. Rusty, next time you fucking drive, okay? Because I'm clearly
sweaty.
Having
I'll try
problems.
To bust his tires.
Shoot him! Shoot him! Why is he paused? Yeah? Game. We're in a high-speed chase here.
Hit him, Cole.
Brambles to the
spin
sleep. She might just think that, you know, she's caught a rabbit. Whoa! A rabbit that screams like her dad. That would be some crazy job dream, wouldn't it? I bit the toy, and when I looked down,
It was my father.
Now is not the time to play around, fellas.
That's normal, Randall, really.
Tram! Deus Ex Machina.
Rusty, that was like 5 seconds delayed. I think you need to be checked for a brain injury. Are you okay, Rusty? Rusty's limping. Oh no, I think that crash may have absolutely ruined Rusty. That was a... Can't wait to do this interrogation next, if there is one. That was surprisingly cool. So I've never had that come up. It might be because I fucked up the interview with both. But both are now in... Now are in the cells. Yeah. Arrested both. Hey, fellas.
I have to say I'm disappointed.
What?
I stood in front of a troop of reporters and made promises. Promises of swift and fearful retribution, and you bring me an armful of vagary and happenstance. You made the department look bad, lad. Do it again and your career as a policeman will come to an abrupt and ignominious end.
Captain, those are some big words.
Back on the streets. Find street criminals, roust them, beat them, and restore some fervor to your police work. Your next case will come when you've revived my faith in your abilities. Now get out of here!
Right. Why is he angry? Was it because a guy escaped the cells? That's not on us. We're not beat cops anymore. Captain doesn't like me. A garden butterfly. Yeah, we got six questions wrong. However, under a third... One? Oh, no. While Hugo Moller stares down a murder charge, Michelle Moller contemplates life as an orphan. I can't... Wow. Unbecoming. I got a one star. And it wasn't even... I wouldn't even say that was entirely my fault. Apparently we missed a clue. I don't remember this. Wow, okay. What's the vehicle damage adjusted for inflation? Yeah, do you know what? That's probably going to be in, like, the thousands. I've probably done, like, tens of thousands. This is set in... I think this is in 1948, possibly 1950. Because I know it's after World War II, shortly, like, shortish after. Cole's come back, and he kind of works his way up. So I think we're in the 50s right now. A one-star case. It didn't really... give us too much. Anyway, here's our flashback to the war as our prize for doing so bad.
We captured two regular armies.
Lieutenant,
I like to think that Cole is, you know, having a dream of his lovely wife.
Until the mission is over, there'll be no
whilst he's now having Vietnam flashbacks.
Here, do you wish to interrogate the prisoners?
I'm in charge.
Another beat. Why they look so sullen? You're wondering why we haven't killed them yet. There is no greater shame than being taken prisoner.
Get this, Golden Boy actually seems to know what he's doing.
Not got the name Kai Soto, Namayo, none of the good
guys. Cole's a weeb.
Kissima, Nani Samadato, Umutarunda.
See that, boys? He slapped that Jap right upside the head.
It was merely to remind him of his place. His shame was the tone of voice that he used with a superior. I respect the Japanese, Corporal.
Respect, we're here to kill the sons of bitches.
Do you know why we are fighting the Japanese, Private?
With respect, sir. These bastards attacked Pearl Harbor.
And why did they attack Pearl, Private?
Because they hate the U.S. of A. and our way of life.
They attacked the U.S. because we cut off their oil.
Wow.
What would we do if another country denied $7,000 to run out?
I was close in the tens. I completely missed the dot on that, and I thought he was going to say $500 is $7 million. Oh, the silk stocking of murder. We are on to our next case. Cole and Rusty have clearly worked up the courage and done well again.
Ah, Phelps.
Hello.
I was just discussing with Finbar here how well you were doing. Have a seat.
We've been doing okay. Finbar.
Yeah, my real name. And you can just forget all about it. Mm. You boys have
also
a
was not expecting World War II flashback in this game.
Poor Hispanic.
How much of this game do you know, Jobson?
Because
if not, I would suggest picking it up.
You seem to have had quite a run of them since.
I mean, if you like Rockstar, like RPG, Zero, fair. So it's GTA but police, as you've kind of seen with the way that I've been playing it. Just your streams, Well, if you want to check out my other videos, then you can get a full idea of the game and how pissed shit I've been at it. And the DA, he like me now, likes me. Mm-hmm. Him hate now me like. And now I have to leave. Wait, no, hang on, go back. That song was incredible. Cole, go back, go back, go back. I need to hear more of this song. Okay. Wait, I want this to start again. Yeah, so this game had a face rig, which is why they had to set it in the 1950s where everyone's hair was really tight back. Because any kind of hair broke the rig and then the facial recognition would fuck up. We're just going to listen to this music to play it out. Oh, Bramble has left.
Oh, she's in the way.
Ooh. Cole's contemplating his decisions. Captain's having a long cigarette. I think Cole's now jigging to the music. I like to think Cole's trying to dance and it's just his flashbacks have hit him so hard he's just like I can't do it, Captain. My legs don't work. I keep thinking about the Japanese. My family is swearing to kill her. His family is swearing to kill me. And if I kill him, he had it coming. So you don't believe, but this song was played at the camps while I was trying to sleep. Oh, a hamburger with steak and onion was 20 cents. Ah, objectives for your current case are listed in the notebook. Yeah, I know what I'm doing, game. I'm listening to the music whilst having serious flashbacks. There's one thing that I am sure. He ain't going to beat me no more. So I tell you that I don't care if I was to die in the egg. Captain, please help. The flashbacks are too hard. Beef stew, homemade. No way. $2.60. That's pretty good. Hamburger with onion. I assume that's it on its own for $2.60. It's like McDonald's. You know, McDonald's. Hey, Bramble. Hey, honey.
Do you want to go outside? Yeah, you need to pee.
Alright, Cole is having some serious flashbacks, which, you know, I think is very indicative. So, I will end the stream. So what I'll do, just in time for his flashbacks. I will end the stream. I will let you guys see some more. Hey, Bramble. Hey, you.
Oh, big yawn.
We got Bramble here with us. This is just, you know, to help tempt people so that the puppy cam can turn on, you know, if she's there. You've had a big day today. Bramble here ate 4 bags of popcorn all by herself. I went to work, checked on the camera, and saw that she had taken the popcorn off the table. And luckily, it's not affected you yet. You need a puppy cam. I need one more follower. Or maybe, who knows, because I think what I'm going to do as well is I'm probably going to move my stream days to Tuesday because I'm doing fencing now. I've picked up fencing with Will now, so I'm going to, I think it's of a Wednesday, it seems. So if that's the case, I'm just going to move my stream day. So Sophie will stream Monday, I'll stream Tuesday. And then, yeah. Good, Bramble. Very good. If the puppy cam was turned on today, it would have literally just shown the golf bag. In fact, actually, it's not set up yet, but it will... Oh, no. It's not set up, so the button's not there. Good. Hold, Bramble. All right. Bramble, do you need to go outside for a wee? Yeah, you do. Cool. Right, I'll end the stream there. Thank you, Jobson and Rosie, for hopping in. Thank you for seeing how Cole has his... you know, handles bad cases. It seems to be him freezing in McDonald's and not moving when having flashbacks. I will see you guys next Tuesday. I will put the VOD up on the channel for tomorrow unedited. and I will also edit this down to a video to conclude into the playlist for at some stage. I'm going to aim for Friday, but it depends how busy I get from fencing. But yeah, have a good evening, you guys, and I will speak to you later. Bye, nerds.